SMB Connect, India's largest integrated solution platform which connects SMEs and entrepreneurs across the nation. Despite several government initiatives and programs, Indian entrepreneurs and SMEs are still facing many challenges. Our mission is to help them overcome those by acting as a catalyst in propelling business growth, promoting innovation, technological advancement and digitalization, and making them successful global players. We have devised 5 pillars to stimulate productivity and growth of SMEs. Start, Manage, Expand series, annual knowledge event series organized concurrently in different cities of India, Advaita, to recognize and celebrate women entrepreneurs of India. Accelerate, entrepreneur awards to honor excellent and accelerating businesses. Listing services, provide a platform to expand digital footprint and customer outreach. Advisory services, help SMEs deal with industry-specific challenges and accelerate growth. Nationally recognized and well-acclaimed in India, SMB Connect is an industry pioneer that supports SMEs. By providing strategic and innovative end-to-end solutions, together let's help small businesses overcome all odds and succeed, because small can be big.
Hello everyone, welcome to MSME Survival and Revival. We have wonderful panelists here today. In the last 2 months, things have turned upside down everywhere, and its impact on MSMEs is clearly visible. MSMEs are today concerned about their survival and revival. So today we have 2 panelists here. Shri Sanjeev Chawla, he is presently director with DC MSME office. He sits at Nirman Bhavan. He has over 26 years of his service to MSMEs. He has worked with different projects on Unito and World Bank projects initiatives for MSMEs. He also presently is having a dual charge of MSME DI Karnal, director MSME DI Karnal. We have other panelists is Dr. Ajay Garg, diversified professional technical officer and social entrepreneur. On the screen we have presently Shri Deepak Jainji. He is Director General, Federation of Indian Industry. I would request Deepak Jainji to please speak for 2-3 minutes on MSME survival and revival before we start our session with Dr. Ajay Garg on financial management and his tips how to survive these crises. Deepak Gandhi, please.
Namaste, Raj ji aur sare jitne bhi upasthit bandhu hain is meeting mein. Sabse bada tough kaam jo aapne mujhe diya, abhi 3 minute ke andar mujhe apni baat kehni hai. 10-15 minute bolte to mere ko aasani rehti thodi si. अगर मैं 1-2 मिनट ऊपर सरक जाऊं तो माइंड मत कीजिएगा. ये जो समय आया है ना जी कोविड का, इतना टफ समय मेरे जीवन में तो आज तक आया नहीं. पहले भी हमने 2 बार मंदी के झलक देखी 2008 में और 1 बार पहले भी, लेकिन ऐसा समय कभी नहीं आया. तो ऐसा कोई रेडीमेड फॉर्मूला हमारे पास नहीं दिखता कि वो पुड़िया हर एक के मन में झाड़ दें और वो एक्टिव होकर के चल पड़े. हर एक को अपना अपना प्रश्न पत्र खुद ही हल करना पड़ेगा. और आज के समय में खाली हम ये कहें भी सरकार पैसा दे दे और एमएसएमई का सेक्टर चालू हो जाएगा, वो भी होने वाला नहीं है. मैं डरा नहीं रहा हूँ, मैं केवल इतना बता रहा हूँ कि हमको एमएसएमई सेक्टर वालों को तैयार रहना पड़ेगा कि इस समय के निकलने के पश्चात में हमारे में से बहुत सारे यूनिट ऐसे होंगे जो शायद चल सकने की पोजीशन में ना रहें। कुछ ऐसे यूनिट होंगे जो इनसिपिएंट सिकनेस की स्टेज में थे, वो शायद चल सकने की स्टेज में ना रहें। चावला जी ऑफ कोर्स मेरे से ज्यादा बेहतर आपको बताएंगे। तो मैं केवल यही अपने साथियों को बोलना चाहूंगा कि आज हमारी जीत इसी में है कि हम अपना स्किल सेट कितना अच्छा मैनेज कर सकते हैं और कितनी जल्दी हम टर्न अराउंड करके अपने सेक्टर, अपने अपने सेक्टर के बारे में विजुलाइज कर सकते हैं। 1 महीना 15 दिन 20 दिन 2 महीने बाद हर एक का सेक्टर खुलेगा। खुलने के पश्चात में हमारे पास ऑर्डर की क्या पोजीशन रहने वाली, वो हमको विजुलाइज करना पड़ेगा। ऑर्डर के बाद हम उस ऑर्डर के अंदर से कितना शेयर अपना ले पाएंगे अपने यूनिट के लिए, वो भी हमको विजुलाइज करना पड़ेगा। और उसको प्रोड्यूस करने के लिए हमारे पास मैन पावर है या नहीं है, अगर बहुत सारे क्वेश्चन मार्क होंगे तो हमको ये भी देखना पड़ेगा कि क्या आज हमारे पास ये जरूरत है कि हम अपना बिजनेस प्लान चेंज करें, जो अब तक इन्वेस्टमेंट हुई उसको एक तरफ करके नया बिजनेस प्लान के साथ मार्केट में उतरें, नई प्रोडक्ट्स के साथ उतरें, नई टेक्नोलॉजीज के साथ उतरें। 2 महीना हमने अभी पीछे जीरो कर दिए, 2 महीना और लगा लीजिए, लेकिन हमको हो सकता नया स्किल सेट अपने लिए भी आइडेंटिफाई करना पड़े। खाली जो मशीन हमारी फैक्ट्री के अंदर है उसको आधार मान करके जीवन नहीं जिया जा सकता। अपने जो बिजनेस करने के और व्यापार करने के स्किल्स हमारे पास आ गए पिछले 10 साल 20 साल 30 साल, जैसे जैसे जिसकी आयु व्यापार में निकली है, तो उन स्किल्स के आधार पे हम आगे कैसे बढ़ सकेंगे। हमारे और पैनलिस्ट इस विषय में आपको बताएंगे। FII ने जितना जोर लगा सकते थे पिछले 2 महीनों में सरकार के साथ जोर लगा करके, कुछ चंद बातें स्मॉल स्केल के लिए सरकार को जोर दे करके मनवाई है। हमारा तो ये निवेदन था सरकार से, भाई जिसकी जितनी लिमिट है, अवेल्ड लिमिट है चाहे सैंक्शन लिमिट है, उसको 50% बढ़ा दीजिए बिना किसी फर्दर डॉक्यूमेंटेशन या बिना किसी फर्दर कोलेटरल के। सरकार ने थोड़ी बहुत उसमें हमारी बात रख ली। बाकी भी और भी काफी सुविधाएं जैसे IAS अधिकारियों की समझ में आया वैसा उन्होंने किया है। इसमें और ज्यादा गुंजाइश हो सकती है, तो आज इसके ऊपर चर्चा करके हम कुछ मंथन निकालेंगे और वो स्मॉल स्केल के हित में वो बात जाए। और मैं राज जी को और आपकी सारी टीम को बधाई दूंगा कि इस बारे में सोचना हमने शुरू तो किया। जब हम सोचते हैं, कुछ कदम आगे बढ़ाते हैं, तो कुछ ना कुछ निकलता भी है उसमें से। आपको बहुत बहुत बधाई राज जी, और आपकी टीम को भी बहुत बधाई। धन्यवाद
धन्यवाद सर, धन्यवाद। बिफोर आई रिक्वेस्ट डॉक्टर अजय गर्ग द पैनलिस्ट फॉर टुडे, एंड आई से वी गो अहेड, आई विल जस्ट लाइक टू ब्रिंग इनटू द नोटिस ऑफ ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स that keeping in mind the vision of Prime Minister Modi ji, SMB Connect has announced to launch very soon local and vocal dot online. This is an initiative keeping in mind the vision of Modi ji that local and vocal online dot online, which will be very soon available for all the MSMEs, and we will send you detailed information through emails and WhatsApp messages where you can list your products and services, and we will try to take you to national and global level. Now let me request Dr. Ajay Gargi to start his presentation, please.
Thank you, Patakji. It is nice beginning, perfect beginning by Mr. Deepak Jainji. The comments which he has given as an opening scene is wonderful comment, wonderful thought. And as soon as you are able to see the screen, kindly let me know so that I can start from there.
Yes, screen is visible, sir.
Okay, perfect. And see that the topic which is assigned to me is MSME survival as well as revival from the perspective of financial management and cash flow. And first I will talk about survival, only then I will talk about revival. And as usual, I will start my today's session with a small story that is related to when Hanumanji was at the doorstep of Sri Lanka. There was a challenge, and before any success, the exam. And only after exam, the success follows. Same thing happened with Hanumanji. He was so powerful, but he has to face the Sursa. And she was more powerful than Hanumanji. Hanumanji started gaining the stature. Sursa also gained the stature. And the Sursa's size was multiple times of the Hanumanji's largest possible size. And the challenge Hanumanji accepted, and he became a smallest possible. And when he became smallest possible, only then he succeeded in exam. Rest of the story I will take at the end of the session. Restart may lead to reach. Be ready for work. Because the moment the one employee becomes positive, you are closed for another 1 to 3 months. That's a challenge. Therefore, one has to be on tenterhook whenever the unit is restarted. Then the survival question is that can you withdraw money from your business for your business? Is it possible? That is a question, because separate money is not there. And business needs money for restart. Can I withdraw money from my business for my business? Let us see how this is possible in today's scenario in every business. Revisit your scrap yard. Reuse or sell your scrap. Otherwise also it is of no use. And bring back these funds into your business. Let us talk in reference to raw material. Whatever raw material is there, usually we are in the habit of storing the raw material for 30 days, 45 days, 60 days, perhaps the times have changed. And some of the raw material, because of aging, might have lost its quality. If your industry is of that type, that the raw material storage which you were doing, this is the time to reduce the size of the raw material stock also. And this money which will be unblocked by way of revisiting the raw material can be used as a working capital own share in the business. And see the store. Visit any industry, any manufacturing unit, and you find 5,000 store items lying there, sometimes 2 years, sometimes 1 year, sometimes 1.5 year. Now, this is the time when you have to, for survival, one has to reduce the size. And to reduce the size, one has to think in reference to the items which are in the store. Return, if you can. Procure it when you need it. Keep your vendor happy. How you will get when you need the store item? Only if your vendor is happy. Can you keep your vendor happy? That is a challenge. If you can keep your vendor happy, then you don't need a store. Let us talk about revisiting the finished goods. Usually we are in habit of keeping the finished goods also with us. No profit or low profit. Don't carry the baggage of unsold finished goods with you. Aging is going to reduce the price of the finished goods. Sell your finished goods even at low profit margin for the purpose of survival. Revisit your machinery. Sell or lease. Track the machine which was not used by you for 6 months. If you have any such machine which is lying at your production floor, which you have not used for last 6 months, then this is the time that either lease that machine to your vendor or sell it. It is not going to give you any money. Your working capital is blocked in that machinery. Revisit electricity load. As in most of the industrial area, it is red zone. Government has allowed only 50% strength 50% increase at a time, you do not require the same load which was sanctioned to you and under which load you were working. Otherwise also, very soon flexible working hours will be allowed and you will be working in smaller shift, small shift at a time, you do not need a full electricity load. And each of you aware that electricity load has its own minimum bill, and you can reduce your electricity bill by way of revisiting your electricity load and getting it downsized so that you can save in terms of electricity bill. Next 6 months, thereafter, you can again go for increase in the electricity load so that you get the benefit of the 6 month survival period. Ask your money for your customer, ask money from your customer. Follow continuously because this is your money. Keep it to your vendor as and when you get the money, because you have to win the confidence of the vendor. If you can win the confidence of the vendor, then you need less working capital and your vendor will be investing for your business. I shall talk that usually we have seen that break-even points in the industry is 65%, 60% or 75%. Kindly revisit your break-even point. Think, can you reduce your price, reduce your cost? If you can reduce your cost one way or the other way, your break-even point will come down. Ask a question to yourself, can I bring my break-even from 65% to 25%? And answer is, if you can persistently, continuously ask this question to yourself, you will be able to reduce this break-even point, if not to 25%, then to 40%, so that you can survive. And as far as sale is concerned, survival strategy can be cash sale, yes. No sale, yes. Credit sale, no. Kick out all credit seekers, howsoever big they are. If they can't pay you today, they will not be able to pay you tomorrow, because they carry the more chances of their revival is less in comparison to you. Let me talk about the revival strategies now, because time slot is 15 minutes. I have to finish it over there. Then now I am moving to the revival strategy. Once you survive and you are able to release the loan, release the money from your own business for your own business, then you can think for the revival. And by revival, I mean to say that first you survive and then you start growing, just like Hanumanji did when he entered the Sri Lanka. And here, government support is already there. The question is, you have to decide whether you want this support or not, because this support is not for everybody, but you may need it if your business needs it. Collateral free additional loan. We have seen that CGT MSC limit is there, and the CGT MSC limit has been enhanced now. And this enhanced limit additional loan will be for a period of 4 years. And 1 year is moratorium. And your bank manager job is not at stake, because this time this additional loan is covered 100% guaranteed. Otherwise, up to now what was happening, that 85% was the guarantee by CGT MSC and rest 15% was the risk of the bank. Therefore, despite CGT MSC, bank managers were not interested to give the collateral free loan. But this additional collateral free loan is 100% backed by CGT MSC scheme. And this facility, this additional window is open till 31st October 2020. There is no hurry. Do not move for additional loan in hurry, because you have to pay interest that may be less. But first survive, only then think of revival. And this time limit, as on date, it has been fixed as 31st October 2020. Let us talk about the second very important and critical government support scheme, that most of the time this has been seen, that SME works at 2:1 debt equity ratio. And bank says that, okay, take 50 lakh from me, but introduce 25 lakh of gross money. And gross money is not there with the SME sector. Therefore, this government support two scheme is there. This scheme is known as subordinate debt for equity infusion. Kindly understand how things will happen in this scheme. Number one, this scheme is for NPA or stressed MSME. Stressed MSME or NPA MSME, but the condition that they are still functioning. If they were still functioning and they can still function, but they are the declared NPAs or stressed MSMEs. Stressed means SMA 1, SMA 2, SMA 3. Even these MSMEs are now eligible to take this subordinate debt. This subordinate debt will be given in the hands of the entrepreneur, not business, but entrepreneur. And then entrepreneur will be asked to put this money back into his business as a equity. And when he will be putting this 1 crore rupees as a equity, then his business will become eligible to take additional debt of 2 crore rupees. Means that your 1 rupee which bank usually asks you for every 2 rupees additional loan is also being put into your pocket in the form of subordinate debt, so that you can bring that money back into the business as a equity, and then you can ask the bank for the additional debt funding. And here there is another part of this equity infusion scheme that government has proposed, that they will be creating 50,000 crore equity fund for MSME sector, so that wherever MSMEs are eligible and workable and profitable, government will be infusing equity directly in those MSMEs. That means basically this equity infusion scheme is divided into two parts. One is for healthy MSMEs, second is for unhealthy MSMEs, or MSMEs who are already under treatment for them. You have to see whether if you are healthy MSME, you are for 50,000 crore scheme. If you are unhealthy MSME, that means NP or stressed MSME, you are covered in this 20,000 crore scheme. I shall tell one more thing which is very critical, that manufacturing sector has been taken care of. Limits of manufacturing sectors have been revised upwardly. Upwardly means micro now up to 1 crore investment in plant and machinery is now micro. Investment in plant and machinery up to 5 crore is now small. And investment in plant and machinery up to 10 crore is now medium. And there are turnover limits also 10, 20, 50. 10, 20, 50, 10 crore for micro, 20 crore for small, and 50 crore for medium. And what is the benefit? Benefit is that there are regular schemes run by MSME DI. Sanjeev Chawla ji is with us. They run a lot of schemes. Then PC MSME also run number of schemes. Then MSME ministry also runs number of schemes. Some of these schemes are eligible only for micro and small sector. That means now outreach will increase. Many MSMEs which were medium earlier and were not eligible to get the benefit will now get benefit of this scheme because of this upward revision in the limit. For example, MSME Samadhan scheme. Samadhan scheme is only for micro and small. Medium are not eligible to get benefit of that. Because now medium are becoming small, therefore they will also be able to get benefit of MSME Samadhan scheme. Let us talk about the next scheme that is very important, very critical, and how this is going to end the MSME, I will tell that also. This is in reference to tendering criteria. If you are MSME who supplies to the government or public sector undertaking, then you shall take note of this, that it has been decided that any tender which is up to 200 crore, now there will be only local tendering. Tendering happens in reference to government department, this happens in reference to public sector undertaking, this happens in reference to ministries, and if tender value is less than 200 crore, there will be only local tendering. global companies debarred from entering into the tender process. What is the benefit? Benefit is better pricing under public procurement policy from MSME sector. MSME sector already given a portion that if they can match the quality and the price of the L1, then they will get 20-25% share for that procurement. We have to see if we are supplying to the government, then here we are likely to get more money, more benefit, and better pricing. Let us talk about another small benefit that has been extended. And this benefit is also in two ways. Way number one, way number two. We need to understand EPF contribution, where you stand. Suppose you have the employees who are, and 90% to 75% of your employees are getting less than 15,000 rupees salary, then you are eligible for complete waiver. Complete waiver means that for another 3 months, Government of India will deposit employer share as well as employee share. If you are not covered in that scheme, then what happens? Then also additional money is being left for the purpose of working capital. That if your unit is not covered under first category, then contribution is getting reduced from 12% to 10%. And rest 2% will be given by the government for employer as well as for employee share. That means the contribution which was being deducted at the rate of 12%, if you are not covered in first scheme, then this becomes 10%. And I shall talk about another point, that how working capital is being taken care of, that tax deduction at source. Part of the, you also get tax deducted when you work, subsequently you also get tax deducted amount, and this rate is being slashed by 25%. That means if earlier the tax deduction rate was 10% in your case, then this is becoming 7.5%. If this was 2%, then it is becoming 1.5%. That means less interest deduction that you are buying will be getting for providing the services or the goods. That means more money for working capital, and my working capital will not get stuck up in the tax matter. Change is only constant, as Mr. Deepak Jain said in the beginning, that he himself also might have to see and might have to look for new businesses. Everyone, business models will change, working style will change, technology absorption will change, pricing will also change. And bitter truth, every business is not going to survive. And bitter truth, many of us will revive and go inside. And I shall end the story here, which I started in the beginning, that once Hanumanji passed in the Sursa test, thereafter whatever he achieved in Sri Lanka during his first visit was exemplary, and this is being remembered even after thousands of years. This is a challenge with COVID. COVID is, CO is for Corona, VI for viral, and D for disease. That's how this COVID is coined, COVID-19, because it started in 2019. And this COVID is just like Sursa. If you will get saved from this, then success is waiting for you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Hopefully, Sandeepanji, I met my timeline. And thank you very much for inviting me on this forum. I will continue. Thank you.
Sir, thank you, and please stay on because we are receiving questions. But we will first of all like to have address by Shri Chawla ji. First of all, let me also thank Dr. Ajay Garg for bringing mythology in this very difficult topic, and also ending the whole session on a sweet note. So now I request Shri Chawla ji to please talk about MSME concerns on survival and revival, and what they can expect from Sir MSME Ministry at this moment. Please, sir.
Respected Pathak ji, thank you for organizing this webinar. I welcome all the entrepreneur friends, my colleagues, to this webinar. As you probably know that MSME Development Institute, Karnal, is looking after developmental activities of MSMEs in the state of Haryana, except Faridabad. And this office is under the Ministry of MSME. Our main role is to provide assistance to MSMEs so that they can start investing in case of new entrepreneurs and existing MSMEs can upscale themselves. During COVID-19, a lot of units have been assisted in getting some licenses, some passes to open the factories, GEM registration, technical information, and all that. Global lockdowns have become a commonplace now for a few weeks, and they're causing economic turmoil. The downturn is expected to be worst since 1930s. The US unemployment soaring to 33%, 33 million, and our own unemployment is crossing 23%. The situation has brought so much of distress. It's a catastrophic kind of global economic collapse. This is unprecedented time. Never in the history of present mankind such scenarios has happened. Now new things are happening. What we do, we as an MSME, what we should do? MSMEs have to be vigilant. They have to observe the happenings. All the countries had bitter experiences during this pandemic. In India, we had no PPEs. USA did not have HCL tablets. Our shoe industry is not working because we do not have raw materials. Europe is not getting components from China. The whole process is stopped. Maruti cannot manufacture or assemble cars as most of the components are not coming from Pune, Gujarat, and there are no markets. So situation is very, very tough. So what our new secretary, Dr. Arvind Kumar Sharma, who joined on 30th April only, what he has done, he has introduced a concept called Champions Control Room. At all MSME DS, Champion Control Rooms have been set up, and it is interesting to note that they work from 8 a.m. in the morning to 10 p.m. in the night. Six officers will be working there in two shifts, and the objective is to provide support and help and hand-holding to all the MSMEs at on real time. It will not be, you know, like we receive the application, we receive the grievance, and then pass it to the next table. We have to resolve the issues. So there are a few components in this champions control room, like grievance redressal, hand-holding, And another thing which our secretary is having the vision that we want to nurture and develop some champions. It is well considered that all the countries have few big industries, like, you know, Apple is there or Google is there or some big companies are there, and most of the GDP contribution are by those companies only. These companies abroad are being manned by the Indian professionals, but why can't we do it here? So that is the main concern of our new secretary, Shri Arvind Kumar Sharma. And with this view, he has started doing work. So this champion desk is available now, and I will request all the entrepreneurs, all the associations to make use of this. There is one site which I will share with everybody. It's champions.gov.in, and we have a dedicated phone line 01842208105, which will work from 8 a.m. in the morning to 10 p.m. in the night. What has happened in the last few weeks? So it's very important to observe, because now we are talking of revival and survival. It's really a big concern. A lot of industries, as Mr. Jain was telling, are not going to function the way they used to function before this COVID-19. But our entrepreneurs have shown strength in this period. The country has shown strength. We didn't have any testing laboratories for COVID-19, but now we have sufficient laboratories which can test corona samples. We didn't have any manufacturing capability in the PPE kits, which include medical gowns, surgical masks, face shields, coveralls, shoe covers, goggles, etc. Now the Ministry of Textile took the charge, motivated some entrepreneurs, and now we have a manufacturing capacity of 2 lakh PPEs per day. And this capacity is of the approved suppliers. And if I include the capacity of the suppliers which are supplying to, you know, the tier 2 markets or which have now been approved, this manufacturing capacity is huge. Now we have sufficient PPE kits being manufactured in the country. We have not less than 10 laboratories which are doing various tests, including blood penetration tests in the country. So I want to say that our entrepreneurs have the strength. Only the thinking, the stimulus has to be there. And to give this stimulus, our Honorable Prime Minister has announced that that manufacturing sector should be encouraged. He has given support for local manufacturing. The reason is this, that during this pandemic, we have observed that we were dependent on supplies from other countries, which has totally failed. China has provided us the kits which did not work, which failed here totally. So there is now a need to manufacture the items here, at least the critical items, at least the items which are required for our health sector or maybe for our essential needs. So what our MSME should do in this, how we can find our pie, what we can manufacture, how we can reorient ourselves. This is the issue which is now in front of us. You all would be knowing that a lot of foreign MNCs now want India. Will we change our labor laws to accommodate them? Will we provide them the skilled manpower? You know, in defense sector, we have an offset policies wherein we have to manufacture 30% of the total procurement from Indian MSMEs. And you would be surprised to know that worth $13 billion USD, this offset is lying unliquidated. So we have huge scope in defense sector, and foreign companies also want to come, but they want skilled manpower, they want vendors, they want the supplies, they want good quality components which can supply into their product manufacturing. So for MSMEs of our region, we can have two kinds of strategies. Like one, we look for another sector, another product which is going to thrive. We stop manufacturing what is not going to be in demand after COVID-19. The second strategy could be we do some incremental small adjustments in our approach. It depends upon the vision and the time horizon of the entrepreneur. If we go for, you know, what kind of products are being imported and which will likely to be promoted here in India, like electrical equipment such as smartphones, computers, they are the huge part of our import bill. So if manufacturing gets a boost, so such kind of products are likely to be manufactured here, and MSMEs can become part of their supply chain. The e-vehicles, the medical devices like ventilators, you know, medical equipment is a 45,000 crore industry in the country. And now with the bitter experience we had during this COVID-19, India will like to manufacture these products within the country. The value addition in India's electronic industry is very limited. We are doing mostly assembly. We are not manufacturing even PCBs. For instance, around 80% of the components used by the mobile handset industry are imported from countries like China. Now we will be discouraging discouraging the imports from China. So what we can do? And if you talk of MSMEs, can we make small items like, you know, some small equipment for cleaning of the house? Because after COVID-19, there will be less kind of domestic help available. Can we have dishwashers manufacturing? Because a lot of households will like to buy dishwashers at their homes. Online education is going to increase in a big way. Everything people will like to do online. Event management pattern will totally change. Now the type of marriages, the type of social functions will be totally different than what they used to be in the past. So our MSMEs have now to find out what are the products they will be able to sell in the market. Hygiene products are going to be in demand. Like, you know, when the schools will open, they are going to have social distances. They will like to have benches which are, you know, 1 meter or 2 meter apart from each student. Maybe new kind of furniture is required. New kinds of toilets will be required. New kinds of this taps, new kinds of door knobs. You know, how do you open the door? If you push it with your foot and open the door, nobody will like to touch the knobs. So there are a lot of changes which are going to be in demand. How we can do, you know, our manufacturing reorientation in case of we are connected with automobile sector, because e-vehicles are likely to come. There will be more demand for personal cars because people will now try to avoid travel by metro. Maybe in the next 4 or 5 years, they will like to avoid Ola or Uber. They will like to avoid taxis. So they will like to have their own cars. Automobile sector is likely to boom. There are chances that people will like to have big kind of houses where they can have more space. Wider roads will be required. People will be interested in more social distancing. So it is up to the MSME to study what kind of sectors are going to be there. And the government is there to support all these initiatives. SIDBI has brought, Mr. Garg has given, you know, the 6 initiatives which were revealed by Honorable FM a few days back. But SIDBI has also brought 3 schemes in which, you know, working capital can be availed. And if a unit is manufacturing COVID-related items, the funds are available at nearly 5% of the rate of interest. So government is there, and our now champion desk is there. We have to now reorient. We have to understand what kind of products will be required. This is a very challenging phase for MSME particularly, because they have limited finance and they have most of the time diverted their working capital here and there. It happens quite oftenly. So managing a working capital is a big issue. As an association, I would always request you to have something program, some training programs on how to manage your working capital. Because in the scarcity of working capital, people have to buy their products at higher rate. They cannot pay wages to the employees. And then there must be some education on the how do we manage our costing of the funds. Mr. Garg has very well given a lot of deliberations on how to do cost cutting. We must have the list of the loans which are high cost loans and the loans which are low cost loans. We need to convert these high cost loans to low cost loans. And then economy of scale is very much important. Government has various schemes, like we have cluster development schemes. We have lean manufacturing schemes wherein we can tell the companies, you know, how to be competitive, how we can reduce our wastage, how we can become competitive. You know, the whole process is like this. Why China had become a manufacturing hub? That is something why we did not become a manufacturing hub? Because our cost of logistics is high, cost of transportation is high, cost of funds is high, we say electricity is, and then these things are partially in our hand, or we can say that not in our hand. But there are few things which are in our hands, like increasing the productivity, giving good training to our entrepreneurs, reducing the wastages, improving the process. We compare with best practices in the world. How many shirts a Bangladeshi worker is stitching per day, and how many shirts my worker is stitching? If I'm stitching her 10 shirts per day and Bangladeshi is stitching 15 shirts per day, I can never be competitive. So we have to compare with the world. What are the productivity levels? What is our efficiency? How we can do cost cutting? And I'm again reiterating this point, that cost cutting can happen by two ways. One are the there are some factors which are in the hands of the government or the environment, or which are beyond your control. But there are some factors which are within your control, MSME control of units. So how we can reduce the cost by controlling the factors which are in our hands, and then we can fight for other factors which are in the hands of. So I will request all entrepreneurs that to have an analysis of what is our business plans, how we had been doing business, and after COVID, this is likely the situation is likely to be opened up in a month or in a 2 months period or 3 months period. So what are the sectors which are likely to boom, which are likely to grow? And then the next question is, if that sector is going to boom, can I change myself? Can I reorient myself? Can I associate with somebody? Can we have some collaboration with some other company, which are the multinational, which are the technologies which are more efficient? It needs to be analyzed. An entrepreneur's job is a very tough job. It is not easy like government employees' job. An entrepreneur has to be dynamic, and he has to be a constant thinker. He has to interact. He has to talk to so many people and think. And lastly, I would say that if you have any kind of query, or you want to have some handholding support, please write to our Champions Control Room, that state control room, which is now at MSME DI Karnal. I have given the number, and I will we will share more details also. And let us see what we can do, how we can reduce the pain of entrepreneur, how we can be a partner with the entrepreneur, can see their resurgence and growth and revival and survival. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. We have, as you mentioned, that you would be very happy to take questions. So we have a good number of questions here. And your suggestion to organize how to manage working capital and cost cutting, I sincerely hope Dr. Ajay Garg will come forward. We will bring one or two more speakers next time, and we will certainly organize similar kind of webinar, how to manage working capital and cut costs, your costs. So meanwhile, I will start reading questions quickly, and either of the panelists can please, to their best judgment, reply. So the first question I am going to read is from Gaurav Sharma. He says, kindly suggest if we would like to manufacture few equipment, what is the platform where we can sell our product? Because this is also a challenge in case we manufacture equipment but don't get buyer, then how we will survive, because it is not regular use product. So he's basically talking more about COVID related products. So any suggestions here, sir?
First, the product they should mention and see what is the approval process. COVID-19 products are health related products. If I'm manufacturing ventilator, then I have to have approval from ICMR, and that Ambu bag ventilators or the primitive ventilators are being approved by DRDO. Then if it is a PPE kit, then its approval is the CITRA, and there are now 9 more labs. So first thing is, what I'm going to manufacture, is it going to be acceptable in the market? If I'm making simply sanitizer, so it's as per WHO specifications. This is number one. Number two is that there is a government e-market platform, GEM. After that, we can register on GEM. In the previous two months, there's a lot of demand of various products.
Please continue, sir.
So there had been a lot of demand, and the standard and substandard, both the products were being sold. Now, as far as my knowledge goes, now that panic period has finished. Now we have enough PPE kits manufacturers who are approved by various labs, which were Ministry of Textiles approved labs. And if you want to manufacture, so see the manufacturing, quality specifications. And there are two associations. One is all AIMED, and one association is for PPPWMAI. We can provide the address. So you become member of those associations, and you will continuously get information from them also.
Ajay Gagri, would you like to say something on this?
Yes. See,
or should I take quality, next question?
Quality is an issue. Market is not an issue. And market, as Sanjeev ji told, GEM portal, in addition to GEM portal, there is another portal. GEM portal is for government procurement, and there is another portal which is run by NSIC, and there also you get very good market.
Sure. So I will quickly take next question from Dolly Basin. She is basically in healthcare and education consultancy services, and she says with the present COVID situation, there is going to be, as both the speakers have mentioned, good opportunities in healthcare, particularly in education. So she wants to understand that usually the schemes are for MSMEs. How a consultant with a large base of, say, knowledge, as well as 20 lakh students already, how she can get into this business, and how MSME benefits she can avail of? Any suggestions, sir?
Yes, sir. The hand-holding of the entrepreneurs who wish to enter into the medical equipment and healthcare products, as earlier audience who asked the question, perhaps maybe the situation that he is not aware where from to get the quality certification. And there comes the role of the consultant who is into the healthcare consulting.
Sure. I have another here, Harinder Rana. Sir, we have hand sanitizing machine. By pressing the leg, we can sanitize our hands. So from where we get approval for this product? He is also thanking the organizers for organizing this. Yes.
For hand sanitization machine, if it is on UV based or plasma based, there are no standards as of now. So our one center at Mumbai has developed a plasma-based hand sanitizer machine. I can connect with them for further guidance. But as of now, they can get a microbiological test. Okay. But we can connect them with the concerned person at IDM Mumbai, and further guidance can be given.
Fine, sir. Surbhi Vijayavargiya She has a question which probably Dr. Ajay Garg would be the right panelist to answer. What are the options to convert high cost loan to low cost?
Yes. I will say that it is the time for debt cutting. Not only low cost, but can you make it zero cost? And example has been set, ball has been set rolling by none other than Mr. Mukesh Ambani. And he is bringing the new partners in his Reliance Jio business with a target that by March 31st, 2021, Reliance will be zero debt company. And now Mr. Anil Agarwal has also moved, Anil Agarwal of Vedanta has also moved in that direction. I will say that rather than bank, it makes sense to bring a partner and say bye-bye to bank if possible. First. Second answer will be given by Chawla ji. I have given my thought. Shall I come with second answer?
We can.
Yes, sir. We will have similar session have next time.
Okay.
Should I go with the next question, sir?
Sir.
There are two. Hello. Can I go ahead with the next question, sir?
Yes, sir. Go for it.
Sure,
sir. What are the benefits from government for online business? This is query from three different people here, including one Vikas M. Large number of youngsters nowadays are in online business. So, what are the benefits? They can avail of from MSME.
First thing I will tell you that this community marketplace, we have more than 3 lakh registered suppliers on this, and there is a worth crores of purchase being done through GeM, and very there are chances that GeM may be opened for private procurement as well in future. So similar something can happen from our MSME. So good experience can be had, and there are no commissions, no hidden costs. So what only marketplace can give you market, that's all. Or what else is expected from this?
Ajay Gandhi, would you like to have some suggestion here? Online business.
I am gold member on NSIC driven MSME portal, and business happens over there. It costs just 5,000 plus GST per year, and business happens over there even for the consultants like me. I will advise MSMEs, because that is for private sector, where government thought process is that MSMEs shall do business with MSMEs. That is the thought process of this NSIC driven another portal run by MSME ministry. And just for the 5,000 bucks, even if you get 6 new customers in a year, you have made your day.
But yes, sir. There is Vinod Gulati. He is saying, I am interested to set up a manufacturing unit for the products like ventilators, but I do not have technical know-how. How can I get the technical know-how for ventilators?
Ventilators, TV technique, we can connect them with the DRDO, or if they wish, we can connect them with the association. You know, this is a very product specific information. We can connect them with the association, and they will be, if they join them, they will have better options.
Sure. Ajay Gandhi, this question is from you, for specifically again by Mr. Vinod Gulati. What shall be the criteria for sanctioning loan to the micro units, their past turnover or their projections? How should they contact government for guarantee?
See, the micro units usually get stuck up because they are already sitting at 2:1 ratio. That means 2 rupees debt against 1 rupee equity. Therefore, his micro unit may have to go for combination of subordinate debt plus debt. Only then his debt. And subordinate debt will happen in the hands of the entrepreneur. He will be asked to infuse this fund in the business, and on the basis of that, then he will become eligible to get the additional debt. And additional debt for working capital is always on higher turnover probability. And additional debt for loan is always for the expansion plan.
Okay. So we have here Tarun Vashesh, he is saying, is there any help from MSME for small scale manufacturers of machines related to COVID-19?
Yes. Sanjeev Chawla ji told just now during his deliberation that SIDBI has a special scheme where for COVID-19 related manufactured products, they are giving loan at the rate of 5% interest.
Sir, aap kuch bolna chahenge isme, Chawla sahab?
One is 5% loan is the cheapest in India. There cannot be loan cheaper than this. And then second is we can give, 50% subsidy under our CLCS scheme. And more so, there are some subsidies by state governments also, in which state he wants to set up the unit.
Fine. So this is the last question I'm going to take. Surbhi Vijayvargiya has again asked one question. Why loan moratorium period not increase as money movement is going to be low for long time? Can we expect something from government on this?
Government has recently announced, a package which was done after long of persuasion. I'm not very hopeful that something new will come very soon, but associations are always trying for this, and it depends upon the bargaining power of the associations. What they can do.
Sure, that is a good hint that associations should take it up. So I think we had good number of questions. I would like to thank both the panelists for taking questions. Now we have our Sunil Kumar ji. He is a deputy director from MSME DI Karnal office. I will request him to kindly give a thanks note, and then we'll close the today's meeting. Sunil Kumar ji, aapki awaaz nahi aa rahi hai.
Unmute me.
Haan ji, aap aaiye.
Thanks a lot to Raj sahab, Sanjeevan sahab, and Madam Rachna Negi for only this kind of very informative session for the MSM units. I will highly thankful to my director, Sri Sanjeev Chawla ji, who has given a wonderful and very informative session this during this webinar, and Sri Ajay Garg ji, who has given his session very informative and really useful to each and everybody during this COVID-19 session. आपका वास्तव बहुत बहुत धन्यवादी हूँ. बहुत बहुत आपका धन्यवाद कि आपने अपना अवेलेबल समय निकाला. थैंक्स लॉट टू ऑल दी विजिटर्स एंड ऑल दी पार्टिसिपेंट हु अटेंडेड दिस सेशन. थैंक्स लॉट टू ऑल ऑफ यू. थैंक यू सर.
थैंक यू सर. थैंक यू ऑल. एंड
सर, एक चीज और मैं और कहना चाहूंगा सर. आई वुड लाइक टू एड वन मोर थिंग. इफ एनीबॉडी एज माय डायरेक्टर आल्सो request to all of the entrepreneurs, if anybody is having any kind of problem related to manufacturing, finance, passage, raw material, or any kind of problem, they can write to our champions control room. We will give the solution, we will give the suggestions, and up to what extent we can help you. We will do it with very limited time. We will come to you, we will contact you, and we will provide each and every support within very limited period also.
हमारे डिफरेंट लेवल पे एसोसिएशन के मेंबर्स आपके बड़े प्रशंसक है, तो मेरे ख्याल से डायरेक्टर चावला साहब भी इस चीज को जानते ही होंगे कि आपने जब ये एश्योरेंस दिया पार्टिसिपेंट को भी वो आपको कॉन्टेक्ट करें, आपके डिपार्टमेंट को कॉन्टेक्ट करें, तो आई कैन से एंडोर्स की यू आर वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इसे कहते हैं अप्रोचेबल एंड हेल्पफुल ऑफिसर वी हैव हियर. सो थैंक यू फॉर वंडरफुल एश्योरेंस टू ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट एंड थैंक यू ऑल फॉर देयर एंड लेट्स होप नेक्स्ट टाइम वी विल हैव डॉक्टर अजय गर्ग अगेन विद अस ऑन हाउ टू मैनेज वर्किंग कैपिटल एंड कट कॉस्ट. राइट सर? थैंक यू सर. थैंक यू ऑल.
थैंक यू सर. थैंक यू.